Good evening, everyone. I'm Maurice Valentine, the Public Affairs and Outreach Manager here at the Montgomery County Office of Consumer Protection. Thank you for joining us at this also important information session on avoiding home mortgage foreclosures. We have a talented panel for you this evening that are eager to present. This is the first of three events that we are a part of during this week, known as Montgomery County Consumer Protection Week, as proclaimed last year by the county executive and the county council. This year is dedicated to one Barbara Gregg, who we lost earlier this year, and who 51 years ago was our department's very first director, one whose memory we hope to honor with this week's events. In addition to tonight, you can find us at the White Oak Library on Thursday afternoon as part of their Getting to Know Your County Government series, as well as at the USO Warrior and Family Center at NSA Bethesda on Friday, presenting on scams affecting our military. Check our website, www.montgomerycountymd.gov/OCP, for more information. And now, without further ado, I'm proud to recognize our moderator for tonight's event, Mr. Ira Reingold. Ira?
Welcome. We're so glad to be here with you tonight. We're so glad to be here today. We hope to provide you with lots of information, particularly those who are concerned or fear the possibility of foreclosure in the near future or having trouble making your mortgage payment. There are lots of resources available to you, and that's what we hope to introduce you tonight and hope to be able to answer some questions that you might have or offer you some help. With me tonight are our four wonderful and well-educated and well-informed panelists who can answer your questions and also provide you what's available for residents of Montgomery County. First, we have Meredith Merchant, who's from the Office of the Commissioner of Financial Regulation. They are Maryland's state regulator of mortgage servicers. Then we will hear from Mary Hunter, who's with the Housing Initiative Partnership, an agency that does housing counseling. Then we'll have Walter Yan from the Latino Economic Development Corporation, another organization that does housing counseling. And then we'll hear from Gretchen Reimer, who's with the Pro Bono Resource Center of Maryland and can talk to you a little bit about some of your legal rights if, in fact, you're worried about losing your home or facing foreclosure. So we'll start with Meredith first.
Great. Thank you for that introduction, Ira. My name, again, is Meredith Merchant. I am with the Office of the Commissioner of Financial Regulation. We are the state agency that regulates financial service providers in the state of Maryland. So what does that mean? We make sure that they are following state law, and that includes all the consumer protection laws. With respect to foreclosure, that means we regulate mortgage companies and loan originators. We also regulate debt management and credit repair service providers, as well as collection agencies and banks and credit unions that are chartered in the state of Maryland. Our office is also responsible for helping to enforce a series of Maryland laws that protect homeowners when they're facing foreclosure. These laws are intended to protect homeowners from scammers or fraudsters who would take their money and not actually help them avoid foreclosure. So first, I'm going to spend a few minutes explaining the foreclosure process in Maryland. And please understand, each state has a different foreclosure process when it comes to mortgage foreclosures. So this is Maryland's. And this is also a summary. I wanted to just hit the highlighted parts and the stages that you as a homeowner need to be aware of and keep an eye out for notices and information that's going to come to you in the mail. So the first thing that will happen after you miss a mortgage payment, your mortgage company will try to get a hold of you. And if they are unsuccessful and they want to proceed with foreclosure, first they have to mail you a notice called a notice of intent to foreclose. Okay. This just notifies you that the mortgage company may file a foreclosure action in court against you. Think of it like a warning. And that's why it's the very first notice that you should receive in the mail. It also has instructions to apply for assistance from your mortgage company. We refer to this as loss mitigation. That's just a fancy word for trying to figure out an alternative to foreclosure. So it's really important that when this notice of intent to foreclose comes in the mail, and it may be like kind of a thick packet with lots of pages, that you take a look at this and you pull out anything that says loss mitigation application or application to request assistance from your mortgage company. The notice of intent to foreclose should also have a phone number and a contact, either person or department or division within the mortgage company who you can call for help with avoiding foreclosure. So keep an eye out for that, please. And don't just throw it away or put it in a drawer. Make sure you pay attention to some of the instructions there and start filling out that form to ask for help. The next thing that might happen if at that stage foreclosure isn't avoided and the mortgage company proceeds to file the action in court, this is the legal action. Maryland law states that they have to wait 90 days after the mispayment. Federal law says 120 days, but just to be safe, think of it as 3 months. So you have 3 months from the first mispayment to try to work out some sort of arrangement with your mortgage company. If that's unsuccessful, then they will proceed with filing the foreclosure action in court. It doesn't mean it's too late, though. That foreclosure action, a copy of it will be sent to you, and it will have something called a loss mitigation affidavit. There's two different types of loss mitigation affidavits. I'm not going to bore you with some of the details, but it's important to keep an eye out for one that will say final loss mitigation affidavit. The final loss mitigation affidavit should have something called a request for mediation form. Don't wait until you get this request for mediation form. Please try to seek help or work out or, you know, contact your mortgage company before it gets to this point. If you're not able to work something out, it's not too late, but it's important that you not intentionally wait. So the request for mediation form, if you're eligible, you need to fill that out and send it back according to the instructions. Mediation is an opportunity to meet directly with representatives from your mortgage company to discuss alternatives to foreclosure. You may do this virtually or in person. The mediation is overseen by a professional mediator, a neutral third party, who's with another state office called the Office of Administrative Hearings. This mediation is a great kind of like a last resort for homeowners, right? If you've been unsuccessful with your mortgage company, not being able to work out some sort of agreement or loan workout or bring your mortgage current, then the mediation is an opportunity to kind of put everything on the table, right? And the mortgage company is required to have somebody there that represents them that can make a decision about your alternatives to foreclosure. So first thing will be the notice of intent that has instructions to apply for help. Then what will happen is the mortgage company proceeds with foreclosure, they will file something in court. You will get a copy of that. You can still seek help at any time in this process. It's much better if you do it earlier. if you do it earlier, then you'll have less to repay. So we're really encouraging you to seek help and to reach out to your mortgage company as soon as possible. So after it's filed in court, you will receive at some point a final loss mitigation affidavit that will have a request for mediation. If you want to participate in mediation with representatives from your mortgage company, then you need to fill out and return that form to the court. You can also have your own representatives with you at the foreclosure mediation. After me, you're going to hear from some wonderful folks from housing counseling and legal service agencies, and they can help you with this process. If no alternative foreclosure is utilized, then the foreclosure sale will happen, okay? If you do participate in mediation, the sale happens quickly after mediation. It may occur as soon as 2 weeks. So again, I just want to emphasize not to wait to request assistance or seek help. It's also really important to keep in mind that if your mortgage company doesn't hear from you, they're going to keep going down this path. They don't hear from you, they will proceed with foreclosure. So it's really important to make sure that they have your correct mailing address and your correct email address if you've signed up for only electronic statements and communications. It's also important that you open and respond to everything that comes from your mortgage company or their attorneys. Once it gets to the legal action, you may start getting information from the law firm that represents them. It's really important that you do this because there are certain timeframes. If you've requested help, your mortgage company is going to need some documents from you to prove income, that sort of thing. So, and you need to get that information to them within a certain time period. So just make sure that they have your correct mailing address and that you are opening the mail from them and that you are responding to it. And if they don't hear from you, then they will keep going down this path. So that's it for my piece. I will see you again later in the presentation.
Thank you, Meredith. That was great. And just a reminder, again, acting early is really important. In fact, if you think you might fall behind on your mortgage, if you're concerned about, you're concerned that you might miss a payment in the future, it's worthwhile contacting your mortgage servicer ahead of time, not even wait till you're in default. But if you anticipate that you may be in default, it's important to reach out to them before then, even so you don't even have to get into this process. Next, we'll hear from Mary Hunter from the Housing Initiative Partnership.
I'm unmuted now. Good evening. Thank you so much for to the Office of Consumer Protection for hosting us tonight and bringing us together to have this important discussion. My name is Mary Hunter, and I'm the director of the Housing Counseling Program at Housing Initiative Partnership. We are an affordable nonprofit housing developer in both Prince George's and Montgomery County. And we also are a HUD-approved housing counseling agency with offices in Germantown and Gaithersburg and Hyattsville. And the services that our HUD-approved housing counseling program provides are what some of the services that I'll be talking about tonight that are really relevant to homeowners who are struggling to pay their mortgage. In addition to foreclosure counseling, we also provide homeownership counseling to help people purchase their first home. We provide rental and eviction prevention counseling for people who are renters and struggling to pay their rent. We have a home sharing program, which I'll talk about in a few minutes. And we also have a financial empowerment center located in Gaithersburg. So I'll proceed and talk a little bit on the next slide about the kind of help that we, our housing counselors, can provide for anybody who is struggling to pay their mortgage or, you know, as was mentioned earlier, even if you're not behind, but you're worried you might be, the best thing to do is to reach out to a housing counseling agency first thing. in addition to calling and reaching out to your mortgage servicer. Housing counselors at Housing Initiative Partnership provide free assistance. We don't charge any fee for any of the services we provide for foreclosure prevention. And this is really important because there are a lot of scammers out there who are charging fees, promising, guaranteeing that they can help resolve your mortgage problem. And I like to say that if anyone's going to be, if you see on TV anyone's charging money or any advertisements for foreclosure assistance, go the other way, reach out to a HUD-approved housing counseling agency to get real free assistance. So what will a housing counselor do to help you? Since the pandemic began, we've been providing hybrid services. So our housing counselors meet one-on-one in a confidential setting, either virtually over Zoom or in our offices in Gaithersburg or Germantown. And the housing counselor will sit down and review all of the mortgage documents of the homeowner and assess where they are in the foreclosure timeline. Are they at the very beginning or in the middle of the end? It's a confusing process. So it's really helpful to have someone help you understand what documents you've received, what they mean, and where, how you should respond to those documents that the servicer has provided or the attorney for the servicer. As part of the assessment, the housing counselor works as an advocate for the homeowner with the mortgage servicer. So after assessing where the homeowner is in their mortgage, what kind of mortgage the homeowner has, the housing counselor can help the homeowner call their mortgage servicer, email, reach out. If there's any, if someone's nervous or having trouble reaching out someone that they can get assistance from, that's where the housing counselor can come in and really make sure that they are able to access any possible workout solutions that the servicer might offer, which can include a modification, forbearance, which is a pause on payments for a short period of time, while if a homeowner is suffering a loss of income. And a repayment plan is often an option. We can help you negotiate those workout plans. And also mediation has been, brought up. Meredith was talking about the option of mediation. Our housing counselors can attend a mediation with the homeowner to help them make sure that, they're showing the servicer all the efforts that they're making to pay the mortgage and to access any workout plans that are available. Additionally, there are other available programs in the state of Maryland. So we'll be sure to screen all of the clients for a program called the Homeowners Tax Credit. Really wonderful option that the state of Maryland has, which has developed, which sets a limit on the amount of property taxes a homeowner has to pay based on the homeowner's income. So it's an income eligible program. So we would look at your income, we would help you determine if you're eligible, and make sure you have to apply every single year. We have homeowners who come back to us every year, and we help them submit those applications if they don't feel comfortable doing that on their own. Additionally, sometimes people are facing foreclosure because they owe homeowners association fees or condo fees. And so that can be a cause for foreclosure action. So we've helped homeowners reach out to their condo association and negotiate a workout plan to avoid that foreclosure. We have this, as I mentioned, sometimes a homeowner just doesn't have enough income to pay the mortgage. Sometimes we see homeowners who are getting older and they're moving from employment into a fixed income. And in those cases, they might want to consider a home share. Montgomery County has created the home sharing program, and our counselors will help match homeowners looking to rent a room in their house in order to increase their income or have a little bit of companionship in their home with someone who's interested in renting a room. So we help vet the home seeker and really are working with both the homeowner and the home seeker along that path towards matching. And then once the match happens, our counselors will continue to check in and stay with the match to make sure if there's any issues that arise, we can help mediate any problems that come up. So home sharing program is new in the county. It was launched last year. It's a great option for people on fixed income who are interested in aging in their home. Finally, a couple more things. We provide information and referrals to other programs. There are many municipal, county, and state programs that help offset energy utility expenses that could really help homeowners. Maybe there's a loss of income in the household. We can connect you with a workforce program. We'll just look at all the options to help you increase income, reduce expenses to make sure you can stay in your home. And there is a state program called the Homeowners Assistance Fund, which launched earlier this year. And our counselors can help determine if you're eligible for Homeowner Assistance Fund and help you apply. And this is a grant of up to $20,000 or a loan of up to $40,000. And so the requirements are the homeowner must live in the residence and have an evidence of a deed and fall within a certain area median income. So we'd love to talk with you more about that. And with that, I'll pass it on and come back a little bit later for the Q&A.
Thanks, Mary. That was really great. Again, just to remind
myself again, as a reminder for everybody who's listening today, it really is important that you're proactive. Don't sit back. Don't ignore the problem. If the problem exists, if you were concerned about falling behind on your home or losing your home, there are great resources in Montgomery County and in the state of Maryland that can help you. You don't need to lose your home. There are services out there and people who can help you and will help you. So please be proactive when that happens. Now we'll turn to another resource for people who are concerned about being foreclosed or worried about being in default on their mortgage. Walda Yan from the Latino Economic Development Corporation. Walda.
Thank you. And thank you for the introduction. I'm sure that I'm on mute, right? You can hear me.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. So yes, the Latino Economic Development Center, that is the name that we use to provide services to our community, our LEDC. Our mission is to help or drive the economic and social advancement of low to moderate income Latinos and other underserved communities. And how we do that is equipping them with the skills and financial tools to create a better future for their families and communities. LEDC is a nonprofit organization that has been providing services in the DMV area for more than 30 years now. We have presence in Montgomery County in the White Oak area. And participants in our programs learn how to build their long-term financial security by buying or staying in their homes, taking control of decisions affecting their apartment buildings, as we work with tenants as well, starting or expanding their small business. LEDC has two departments, the housing department, actually three now, the housing department, the small business services, and the direct community invest department. So our services include included in the housing department. LEDC is a HUD certified housing counseling agency, and all of our counselors are HUD certified as well and bilingual. We focus on helping low to moderate income residents in Montgomery County and in Maryland in general with support to take control of their financial health, understand what are the tools that they can use to establish or repair the credit. We know, especially among the Latino community or the immigrant community, they don't know how to work with their credit, how to establish the credit, or how to take care in general of their financial health. We also help them understanding and learning about the process to become first-time home buyers or to save their home if they are facing financial hardship that can put them in risk of foreclosure. our small business department offers business loans, small business loans, and as an advice to local entrepreneurs. And our direct community investment department partners with governments in the area and private entities to rapidly deploy financial assistance, especially during the pandemic. This is a department that was created during the pandemic to support the communities to get assistance. As a housing counseling department, or working with a housing counselor, as I mentioned, LEDC is a HUD certified housing counseling agency. Our counselors will work with you as in a one-on-one basis individually. We provide homeowners with the support to understand their situation and their options if they are already facing foreclosure or they are behind on the payments. We are gonna help you understand what are the options that you have to avoid foreclosure if that is what the homeowner decides. Discuss their financial hardship as part of our individual counseling services. And this conversation is crucial to understand what is and their situation and how we can help you as a housing counselor. Gather all the information and documentation that is required by your servicer, the financial institution that is holding the loan, and all the documentation that is necessary to apply to any loss mitigation option or program, as the HAP program that is available at this moment for homeowners in the state of Maryland. Also, we are going to help homeowners to understand how to calculate their income, their expenses, how to create an emergency budget that is important to overcome the hardship situation that they are facing in this moment. Review the credit to understand what is the level of debts and if there is anything else that we can help to support them to overcome the hardship situation and take care of the credit history that is going to be important later on. With all that information, we are going to help the homeowners or the household to create a sustainable household budget, or what we call an emergency budget, and identify any other option that can help the homeowners to avoid foreclosure. And as I mentioned before, and Mary also mentioned that we have this option available at this moment, which is the Homeowners Assistance Fund program, or the HAF program, that can support with payment for your mortgage if you are behind, utilities also if you are behind, or your taxes. So is a very valuable resource that we have available at this moment to support the community and homeowners that are behind. Another thing that a housing counselor can, another support that a housing counselor can provide is helping you since the beginning to apply for the HAF program and develop any action plan, understand what is the process and what are all the steps that the homeowners need to take to apply for these programs, or to navigate the system to work with your services. Those are the services that LEDC can provide. So I'm gonna repeat what my other, the other panelists have mentioned, that if you are behind, please look for help. In the state of Maryland, there are nonprofit organizations available around the state. So look for a nonprofit organization that is going to be helping you without charging you for these services. There are options, there is support available that is free for you. and you are not alone in this situation.
Thank you, Waldo. That was great. And again, just to remind everybody, the state of Maryland and people in Montgomery County, there are really great resources available for you. We have a regulatory agency, the Office of Commissioner of Financial Regulation, who can help you. We have housing councils who can help you and are here to help you. And finally, let's turn to Gretchen Reimert of the Pro Bono Resource Center of Maryland and talk about some of the legal resources that are available to you.
Thank you. So I want to reiterate what everyone on the panel has said before me. What we would encourage every homeowner who's struggling to do is to make sure that they are working with both a housing counselor and an attorney if they actually get into the foreclosure process. So this slide is a visual representation of the overview that Meredith gave at the beginning of her presentation. And it's just a different way to look at the legal process in Maryland for foreclosure cases. So some of the key points to be aware of is step number 3 is when a notice of intent to foreclose is issued. It's mailed via certified mail and first class mail to every owner of the property. So even owners who are not necessarily on the loan as a borrower, a listed borrower, every owner, homeowner gets notices under Maryland's law. So the first notice is the notice of intent to foreclose under step 3. Once a homeowner receives a notice of intent to foreclose, they are eligible for legal services through the state of Maryland. The Pro Bono Resource Center is an arm of the Maryland State Bar Association, and we train volunteer attorneys to represent homeowners who are in foreclosure. We also hold in-person clinics to help homeowners, and we hold phone consultations for homeowners who are unable to attend a clinic in the timeframe that they need. So once you receive a notice of intent to foreclose, you're eligible for legal services. Hopefully you're already working with a housing counselor at this point, and you should be looking for legal services to support your efforts. The next important step is step number 4. That is when the formal foreclosure action is filed in circuit court. Once the order to docket is the name of the documents that are filed, it's roughly 50 to 100 pages long, so it's something that you can't miss. The substitute trustees, the foreclosure attorneys, will ask someone to try to personally serve the home. Again, every homeowner gets a copy, so there may be multiple copies that are coming to the home. Once this action is filed, you know that a formal foreclosure case has been opened in circuit court. The train has left the station, and it's really important to take action as quickly as possible. The next important step to know is step number 5. Now, if you see between 4 and 5, if you don't start taking affirmative action to slow down the foreclosure process, by default, the foreclosure action at some point will move forward and a foreclosure sale will be scheduled. In Maryland, homeowners have a right to request a mediation session before a foreclosure sale can be scheduled, but they have to take affirmative action in order for that to happen. So the forms that allow a homeowner to request mediation get sent directly to the homeowner. The instructions are very clear. The forms are very easy to fill out. One of the key distinguishing characteristics of these forms is the forms come with 2 envelopes. One is addressed to the circuit court where the case was filed. The second envelope is addressed back to the foreclosure firm that is handling the foreclosure. So the instructions on the request for mediation form say to fill out the form, send the original form to the court, send a copy of the forms to the foreclosure attorneys. We encourage people to mail those forms via certified mail so that you have proof that you mailed them on time. The forms have to be returned 25 days after they're filed with the court. So to be safe, I would encourage you to mail them around 21 days after you receive them. If you have any concern about the timing, working with a housing counselor or an attorney can help you make sure that you're meeting any deadline that comes up in your case. If you request mediation, once you submit the request for mediation, the court will process the paperwork and a mediation will be scheduled in approximately 45 days. Typically, there's only one mediation. There's only one opportunity to go to mediation. So it's kind of one shot to resolve things with your servicer if you haven't been able to already. And one of the reasons to request additional time when you're able to do so is because circumstances can change. Maybe you fell behind because you lost a job or something happened and there was some kind of financial setback in the family. Well, over time, sometimes someone gets another job or a new family member moves in who has a source of income that can contribute. There are lots of things that change over time. And one of the advantages of working with a housing counselor and an attorney is they can help you adapt quickly to those changes when they occur. So once the mediation concludes, a foreclosure sale can be scheduled. My experience in Montgomery County is that they're scheduled roughly 4 to 6 weeks after the mediation concludes. Once a foreclosure sale is held, there is no longer an opportunity to save the home. So if you have any hope of trying to save the home, you must act before a sale occurs. Once a foreclosure sale notice is mailed, there's typically only 10 days or so before a sale is scheduled to occur. And once you're at that stage in the process, typically the best way to stop a foreclosure sale is to file for bankruptcy. A lot of people are daunted by the idea of filing for bankruptcy, which is another reason we want you to talk to an attorney as soon as you possibly can in the process. Bankruptcy can allow you to save the home. It can also allow you to sell the home. So in the current market, a lot of people, even if they can't save the home from foreclosure, they may have a lot of equity in the home that they want to protect. If the home goes to a foreclosure auction, homeowners are likely to lose a substantial amount of any equity that they have in the home. So if you can't save the home, you can still sell the home through a bankruptcy and protect or salvage whatever equity there is in the home value. Once a sale occurs, there are still options, even though you can't save the home. You don't have to be out of the house immediately. There's a period of time that you still have to remain in the home. After the sale occurs, there's a separate eviction process that happens. We tell people typically to be focusing on their transition once a sale has occurred, and to be aiming to be out of the home in a 30 to 60 day timeframe. And there are programs to help people once they're at that stage in the process. So I think what I want you to know is that there is help available for you if you are finding yourself struggling. As I said, PBRC offers in-person clinics, and we also offer phone consultations for people who want to speak to an attorney as soon as possible. And the best way to get in touch with PBRC is to contact our foreclosure prevention unit at 443-342-4262. That's 443-342-4262.
Thank you, Gretchen. That was really important legal advice. Again, I would urge people not to be passive, but to take action. There's lots of resources. There's lots of housing counseling and legal help available to you. One other thing that's really important for folks to understand when they are potentially faced with foreclosure is on our panel today are people here that are here to help you. Unfortunately, when you fall behind on your mortgage, other people often find out about that, and you will be receiving notices and letters. You may see signs. You may see all sorts of people approaching you who don't have your best interests at heart. We see, in many instances, we see the growth of foreclosure scams or people who are out there to take advantage of people who are vulnerable, who are worried about losing their home. And to that, I'll turn back to Meredith. We'll talk a little bit about some of the scams that are out there and some of the things that people need to be aware of so that they're not harmed even more than when they're faced with foreclosure. So Meredith.
Great. Thank you, Ira. Hello. And I told you I'd be back. So one of the questions that I often get is, how did this person even know that I was in foreclosure? So remember when we were talking about the process, once it's filed in court, that means it's a public record, okay? So you'll get lots of stuff in the mail. Remember I was telling you to make sure you open up mail from your mortgage company, that's important. You may get a letter with some resources from our office. Again, we're the State Office of Financial Regulation. And you may get a postcard from your local housing counseling agency. So it can be really hard to kind of sort through what's legit and what's not. So here are some red flags to watch out for, okay? Nobody should be requiring you to pay money to them in order to help you get a loan modification. There are free, reputable, state and federally certified housing counseling agencies. You've heard from two today that can help you do this for free. If you need help navigating like the court process, you just heard from Gretchen from the Pro Bono Resource Center. There are also legal service agencies that may be able to help you for no fee or for low fee, depending on your income and other eligibility requirements. Another red flag is if the individual or business is an out-of-state attorney or law firm, or if they're working for an out-of-state attorney or law firm. They should not be telling you to stop communicating with your mortgage company. In the beginning of the presentation, I kept reiterating how important it was to stay in contact with your mortgage company. So anyone that tells you to stop talking to them, red flag. They should not be scaring you into acting quickly to sign documents that you don't understand or have time to read. Now, if there is a loan workout or some other option, then yes, there are documents for you to sign if you work out an agreement. The key here is somebody rushing you and not giving you the time to understand what it is you're signing. There are also some scammers that may sign or try to coerce you into signing over the deed to your house to them. That's also not part of a legitimate like foreclosure alternative. And any business that also doesn't have some sort of written agreement with clearly specified terms, any legitimate like debt management service provider must have an agreement with you that clearly specifies what they're going to do, including the fact that you may not qualify for mortgage assistance. And then of course, anyone guaranteeing anything also should be a red flag for you. So finally, just some resources from our office. Like I mentioned earlier, we are the state regulator, okay? So we make sure that mortgage companies are following state and federal law, and also that debt management and credit repair services, collection agencies, and state chartered banks and credit unions. We're the state office that supervises the activities of those businesses, okay? So if you think that your mortgage company has treated you unfairly, or if you need to report a foreclosure prevention scammer, you should come to our website, or you can shoot us an email, or you can call us. I don't have the phone number up there, but it's on the next slide, for help with your mortgage company. Please keep in mind, though, that our office, we're not housing counselors and we're not attorneys. We don't represent you in court. So if you need help with like your loan modification or trying to navigate the process, then you need to call one of the agencies that just spoke. If your mortgage company, for instance, isn't responding to your requests for help, Your mortgage company is also, if you ask for a copy of your payment history, Maryland law says they have to provide it to you. You have the right to be informed by all of your by your mortgage servicer of all of your options. So if you think that your mortgage company has done something wrong, contact our office. It's really important that we know what's going on out there. So you can submit a complaint online. If you're not sure whether or not your issue is appropriate for submitting a complaint, then call or email us first and we'll let you know. We also enforce the laws protecting people against foreclosure scammers. I was just talking about that. So if you need to report a foreclosure scammer, the process is just the same. You submit a complaint or contact our office. We also have a helpful fact sheet that has your rights as a homeowner in Maryland, tips for communicating with your mortgage servicer. A copy of that is available on our website. Our website is labor.maryland.gov/finance. That slash finance is really important so that you go to the right website. So I'm going to wrap it up and turn it back over to Ira. We probably will handle some questions.
Thank you, Meredith. And I just want to reiterate what Meredith said. If your mortgage servicer is not treating you right, has made a mistake in their accounting, either negligently or intentionally, it is really, really important to file complaints with Meredith's office. It not only will help you, but it will help other homeowners, because it is certain that if they've made a mistake with your account, they've made that mistake with other people as well. So it's very important that the state regulator hears that so that we can create new laws, new rules, but also keep those mortgage servicers in line so they treat people far better. Okay, with that, I'm going to ask, we have several questions that we've received that I'll ask our panel. We'll go for about 10 more minutes and then we'll be done for the evening. So first, I have a friend who lost his job but is current on his mortgage loan. Is he eligible to apply for loan modification or other assistance that we've talked about tonight? Who should the person do first? They're not behind in their mortgage yet, but they've lost their job and they're afraid they're going to fall behind. Mary or Walda, would you like to handle that question?
Sure. Yes. Sure. So the friend is not behind on the mortgage yet, and that's a really good time if they know that they're going to have trouble paying the mortgage, it's a really good time to reach out to their mortgage servicer and to a housing counseling agency. There might be options that the mortgage servicer might provide. It could be a forbearance option where we know that there's going to be a loss of income and that can be proven, and the mortgage servicer could potentially offer to give a forbearance, like I said earlier, a pause in the mortgage payment. Until the homeowner can, you know, get a new job and bring in more income. So there are definitely options, and for the friend, and certainly, the mortgage servicer may not provide a forbearance, may not have those kind of options, but there might be state or local funds that could help for the friend if they need some assistance as a bridge until they're able to get a job. And so that's where the housing counselor can come in and help connect homeowners who are worried about paying the mortgage to those options that are available. Local community resources might be available.
So again, just to reiterate, please do not wait to fall in default, but act when you anticipate that you may be in default. There are lots of resources, as Mary has said, available to you. Okay, next. Now, Walda, I know this is something you've never heard before. I applied for a loan modification months ago, and my server has asked me for the same paperwork over and over again. Is it allowed to do this? What should I do when the mortgage servicer keeps losing my paperwork?
Yeah, first time that I heard about that, definitely. It's very common that it happens with servicers that they ask for the same documentation, especially in this second wave of foreclosure crisis. We saw that in the first wave back in 2008, 2009. It was very complicated, and then they got better, but then things, the financial crisis, we overcome the financial crisis. The loss mitigation departments that they put together during that time disappeared, and everybody went back again to loan originators, and they lost the expertise and the experience that they got working with homeowners during that time. So we are back again this time with the same situation, the same problem, that they don't have a dedicated point of contact to handle the cases, so the documentation got lost. So I'm gonna get back to our recommendation as a housing counseling agency. As a housing counselor, we are gonna recommend to work with a housing counselor so this situation can be avoided. We know how to make them accountable for the work that they had to do. So it's gonna be easier for a homeowner that is working with a housing counselor to avoid this situation where the servicer requests for the same document at many or several times. So my recommendation for this situation is gonna be to work with a housing counselor as soon as possible. And always keep also track of when you submit the document, if you are sending the documents by email, to keep your emails, save your emails. If you are sending them by fax, to also keep the proof that you sent it by fax. Or if you are gonna be sending documents by mail, regular mail, to always send it certified. So you can, as a homeowner, you can have a proof that you send those documentation. But the better way is to work with a housing counselor.
Great. Thank you so much, Walt. And again, for folks who are out there listening to this, dealing with mortgage servicers can be very difficult and very problematic. Do not think it's you when they're not responding to you. It's really important to work with professionals who know how to deal with these servicers, because oftentimes it will take somebody from one of these agencies to get through them and to get them to respond appropriately. It's not you, and it's important to reach out to professionals who can help you do that. Okay, another question. This may be our last question, we'll see. I've been trying to get a modification, and Gretchen, this will be for you. I've been trying to get modification with my servicer for months. I've been working with them. It's related to the last question, but again, servicer is not being responsive. They keep putting me off. I keep working with them. They keep saying we're working on it. And the next thing I know, I get a notice of intention to foreclose. What can I do? What can I do when they've now proceeded to foreclose, even though we're in negotiation and they're talking about working out a servicing agreement, with a modification of my loan? What are my rights there?
So one of the things that's really important to understand, is that there are two things happening simultaneously in a foreclosure case. On one level, there is communication between the homeowner directly with the mortgage servicer to see if there's a way to resolve the issue and help the homeowner get back on track. At the same time, at some point, there's a legal process that begins. And those things happen on parallel tracks. So I'm going to reiterate again how important it is to work with a housing counselor. They can make sure that when you are submitting information, that it actually is the information that the servicer is looking for, that it's complete, that it's accurate, that it's current. Sometimes the servicer got information that is so old that it is no longer useful to them in their process, and a counselor can help you stay on top of that and make sure that you're sending current information in. And an attorney can help you make sure that you're aware of the legal process as it's proceeding, and to the extent you have an ability to challenge the legal process, that you do so in a timely fashion so that the servicer does complete their review of your application before the servicer proceeds with the next step in the legal process. So I can't emphasize enough how important it is to have both a housing counselor and an attorney on your team. They can support you and guide you through the process, make sure that things are being handled properly by the servicer, and also make sure that you are can move through the process with as much grace and ease as humanly possible.
That's great. Thank you, Gretchen. Again, I just want to reiterate this point that when you have housing, when you are in negotiations and trying to work out a loan modification and you receive a notice of foreclosure, do not just assume that because you're in notification, you've received, you're in negotiation, that that foreclosure can't proceed. You need to respond to both activities. You need to keep negotiating, but you also need to reach out to an attorney because you cannot ignore that legal process. It's essential that you handle both. With that, I want to thank you for listening, for being here. Please be, the one word again, I cannot say this often enough, is be proactive. When you think you're going to be in default or you are in default, there are resources throughout the county and the state who can help you. Please take advantage of it. There's no reason that anybody in Maryland who have some resources should, in Montgomery County, should lose their home to foreclosure. There are ways to stop foreclosures. There's help out there for you. And some of the contacts of the people who you've heard from today is now up on your screen. Please reach out. Reach out to the Office of Consumer Protection if you need to hear or learn about some of those resources again. You can be helped. There's no reason for you to lose your home, and there are people out here who can help you. Thanks, and have a great night.